And now, the Extreme Wrestling Federation presents Battle of the Brands.
Man upstairs says you're going somewhere, cause you live and then you gotta die. Looking up high, I know just why the sky's so bright tonight. Cause every single star is somebody we love and we never have to see.
Hello everybody, welcome back to the channel. Welcome to Battle of the Brands. We'll start things right off with King of the Ring.
The following is scheduled for one fall, making his way to the ring from Cleveland, Ohio, weighing in at 195 pounds, Youngblood.
Youngblood making his way out here for our first match. Of course, I'm James Green alongside David Kusar.
Best color commentator in the game. Let's go. Live from Manchester, England. Honestly, I'm very excited after what we saw from Evolve with the Final Four and the King of the Ring. You know, Youngblood's status, actually his spot in this whole tournament, questioned, as said by Austin Insanity. Leon did a great work as the United States champion. Austin Insanity is the only former world champion in the tournament. Cortez actually competed for the Evolve Championship, which leaves Youngblood being the only unproven talent in this tournament.
Yeah, I mean, the most notable thing he's done is won the tag team titles, but in a singles tournament, how credible is that?
Exactly. Especially as Leon said, his biggest victory was over his brother, and his brother was injured.
But Youngblood, in order to get to the King of the Ring finals, he'll have to go through Cortez Maldonado. So that's not if he has anything to say about it.
And his opponent from Mexico, weighing in at 241 pounds, Demon Warlord!
There is Cortez Maldonado, who did end that confrontation of the Final Four, standing tall in the ring on his own brand in Evolve. As the lone Evolve competitor here, he's looking to finally get another shot at that mountaintop, and this time actually pull the trigger, or at least finally get the victory.
Yeah, like you mentioned, Cortez, the only person left from Evolve in this tournament. So if he's able to go all the way, that's saying a lot for him and his company.
Quite right. But let it be known that whoever wins this match has to face the winner between Leon DeSanta and Austin Insanity in the finals. So this is not even going to be their toughest matchup, because they got either a former Universal Champion or arguably the greatest United States Champion waiting for them.
Very true. But nonetheless, we're set for an incredible match between these two as it gets underway.
Cortez with this. Ooh! Paler DDT to start us off, but doesn't keep Youngblood down for good. Or down for long at all. Ooh! Goodness.
And if you're Cortez Maldonado, I think he's got the right idea. Get the big moves out of the way to start this off. Make it a quick match so you're not exhausted for the finals.
Exactly, as most of his moves were targeting the head, which could trigger a concussion. And, oh, throw off the balance of Youngblood, but it did little to affect his balance there.
Wait, springboard forearm.
Use a little high flying there from Cortez on Youngblood. Interesting strategy. Goodness, those strikes. Ooh.
Maldonado desperate to get this victory tonight, making him one step closer to the King of the Ring finals. But Youngblood had something to say about it. They're going for the pin, just not even a one count.
Youngblood, oh no, Cortez. Cortez, like, he saw it coming from a mile away. Ooh! Goodness. And What a kick there to the back of the head. Young Blood with a kick of his own. There we go, that pad. Head scissors takedown.
Going for the pin on Maldonado. Gets a one count, but not even close to being three.
Of course, oh wait, he's got him. Hurricanrana there from Youngblood. I thought he was going to go for a Poisonrana. But wait a minute, he's going to the top rope.
Going high risk. Potential for high reward here. Waiting on Maldonado to get back on his feet. And oh my.
Another Hurricanrana sending Cortez out. Oh!
Maldonado thinking on his feet.
Goodness. And then a suicide dive hitting Youngblood. The shoulder made contact with the back of Youngblood's neck. Oh!
Lariat turns him inside out on the outside. You still need to get back in the ring to put this match to its end.
Count of four, Cortez getting back in, but Youngblood back to his feet almost immediately after that Irish whip. But catching his breath, this could be a smart move. He has till the count of 10 to answer the call. Goodness. Cortez is on him.
Definitely, and he's not slowing down either, but oh! Youngblood rolls out of the way.
Oh no. He might get caught lacking here. Oh, he got caught lacking.
Caught the knee to the stomach. But fighting back here.
And again, catching him with the head scissors takedown. Goodness, and now he's going for the pin.
To move on to the finals, just a one count.
I know, I'm pretty sure both of these two want to conserve their stamina, to conserve their energy for the finals, but judging by how vicious they are with each other, they might have to go pedal to the metal for this match just to get a victory.
Luckily, they'll have a little bit of a break after whoever the victory may go to, but break or not, they're going to be tired after going through this match. And I guess another good thing about that, same can be said for their opponent, but still, you never know how long each match is going to be and how gruesome it is.
Exactly. Oh, wait. Oh,
my.
Just got flipped inside. Wait, Youngblood kicked up, but now Cortez got him in a sleeper.
Cortez got him locked up in that sleeper hold. But Youngblood fighting back.
With that jawbreaker to get him out of there. Oh, wait a minute. Now he's got him in the crossface.
Youngblood's locked it in. Cortez has nowhere to go.
Exactly. This
changes his mind. Oh, my.
Was that a shooting star press? The way he contorted the air. It looked like he may have been going for a moonsault, but had to switch it up. But oh! Wait. Cortez isn't moving. No way!
I think Cortez might have been knocked out, but regardless, Youngblood gets the dub and he's going to the finals.
Are you kidding me?
We'll see him later tonight.
Exactly. Job well done.
But now we're moving on. We're going to find out who Youngblood's going to face in this next match. Leon DeSanta and Austin Insanity going head to head.
Exciting matchup again. Like I said earlier, whoever won that matchup was not going to have an easy night afterwards, because it's Leon DeSanta and Austin Insanity, the greatest workhorse champion and former Universal Champion. And this might be a dream matchup here from this whole tournament.
It is definitely one people have been looking forward to.
It's scheduled for one fall, making his way to the ring from Tijuana, Mexico, weighing in at 228 pounds, Leo Tejano.
I mean, think about it. These two are arguably the top two favorites in this whole tournament. Of course, you had others like Reapy Killer 13 and Santos Fox, but obviously two of those names were eliminated in the first round.
We're gonna see them in our main event too.
Exactly, thanks to the help from each other, and also Youngblood pulling up the big upset by eliminating Santos. But
that's
these
actually
two still
the
remain.
Second time Youngblood has defeated Santos Fox. I want to put that on record.
Quite right.
So, I mean, that's saying something for Youngblood. Obviously, he's made it to the finals of King of the Ring now, so.
As we await the entry of the only former world champion in this tournament, Austin Insanity, the man who's been trying to climb back to the mountaintop for a very long time. The mountaintop for a very long time, and especially like when you've already been to the mountaintop, especially when you've had a world championship, being a former universal champion, and being and going so long without having the taste of that glory again, it does something to you.
I mean, he's hungrier than ever, if that's what you're getting at. Absolutely. But Leon DeSantis just as hungry. He has yet to reach that top of the mountain. You say he's the greatest workhorse champion, and that may be true, but he still never held a world title.
Exactly. It's Leon with the Hurricane Rana on the former Universal Champion, now going up to the top rope.
Leon wanting to end things early with the diving elbow.
Goodness, what an elbow drop. The distance he covered there. Almost ended it early there.
Already a two count in this match. At this rate, we'll be done in 2 minutes. Oh!
Austin was going for something, but Leon caught him with that German suplex.
Now collar and elbow. Leon sent to the corner. Oh!
Ooh. I'm just washing the face with the boot. Oh, no. Austin. Oh! Did he just pull out a springboard moonsault?
I've decided not to question anything Leon DeSantis does anymore.
I'm talking about Austin Insanity. I did not expect that from him, but that, again, that just goes to show what I said earlier. Being off the mountaintop does something to you. It makes you want to take risks. Especially being this close.
Now Austin
And
got Leon in a bad position. Oh my goodness.
Oh, Austin. I'm sorry, Leon. Almost got Mealy back up. Like you said earlier. Oh! That was a flatliner.
On the outside as well.
Count of five. These men need to get back in the ring.
I wouldn't be surprised if Leon left Austin out there stranded. He has a history of that in this tournament, but no. Besides, he's better than that tonight.
Now he's going for the pin now. So the ref trying to get in position. Doesn't even get a one count.
Took too long. I'd say foul play by the referee there. But who am I?
Maybe onto something here. And so maybe Austin with that combo there. Now he's just looking like he's stalking his prey there. Goodness, those knee strikes us to the stomach.
The rib cage. Leon DeSanta definitely feeling it.
Again with the boot wash.
Just a one count.
Wait a minute. Oh, wait. Leon with the twisting neck breaker. But it didn't keep Austin down. Ooh!
Devastating stomp. Oh my.
But that's followed up by a devastating knee from Austin.
Now what's he thinking here? No!
Ooh! He gave him a stomp in return to his hamstrings.
Oh my.
Oh, and a springboard dropkick to the back of his neck.
Oh.
And then a Superman punch.
That might be it. Two. No.
Leon. Oh no. Arms hooked. Oh. Oh, wait a minute.
Oh, but
Death
no.
Rider. That was out of nowhere.
Out of nowhere, that doesn't do it though.
But now Austin's ready to go to the top rope. What's he got planned here? Oh, went for a knee drop, but Leon moved.
Quick thinking from Leon.
Now,
Leon's in control.
Oh, goodness. Twisting that arm. Oh no.
Haunting Austin insanity and oh no!
Oh, and he nails it! That's gotta do it.
Austin's gotta be out here. Not quite!
He's not? Oh! Oh!
Oh!
I don't know what Leon was going for there, but it was gonna be devastating for sure. Austin taking back control of this matchup. Oh, he didn't get all of that springboard forearm, but he got enough.
Enough to take Leon
down.
Going
for a pin.
But it wasn't enough to put him away. Raining strikes.
Those lifts.
Insanity going up top once again.
Oh, goodness, what a stop!
He's not done yet.
There's a reverse. Oh! Leon may have went for a spear, but he moved out of the way.
Dodged it.
Oh. And an inverted suplex.
Going for the
pin. Going for the pin.
No, not enough. These two are putting each other at their limit. Let's not forget, one of these two has to have another match tonight.
Exactly. Oh, goodness. Leon wrenching that arm. Oh! Twisting it in all sorts of directions.
Every direction but the right one.
Exactly. Now Leon, oh,
oh my.
Surfboard using the ropes as leverage. Wait a minute, Austin.
Ooh.
Kicked up. And now delivers those two clotheslines, got the leg, swept.
No. Austin goes to put away Leon. Will it be enough? No. Adrenaline is pumping, but it's not pumping enough to end this match yet.
Oh, oh, goodness. Those forearm strikes into
a
death rider. And that will do it.
So our finals in the King of the Ring tournament will be Youngblood versus Austin Insanity.
Youngblood, I hope you're ready. I hope you saw what you needed to see. Because you got a former Universal Champion headed to you.
That's going to be a heck of a match. But we're moving on. The Clash of Champions. I don't know what you call it. Champion versus Champion match. The Valuables versus Legacy. Of course, the Valuables representing Fight. Legacy representing Battle, who just won the titles on the last episode of Battle.
Exactly, as here come arguably the greatest tag team in XWF history.
The following contest is a tag team match set for one fall. On the way to the ring, at a combined weight of 455 pounds.
At this point, I don't even know if it's arguable. I believe they're, what, seven-time champions?
You might be right. Let me you might be right. Seven times? If it's seven times, then they for sure got it.
Yeah, they collectively are seven-time champions. Diamond Rush is actually an eight-time champion.
Definitely speaking, yeah. So, yeah, they definitely got it.
That was the short stint of which the Valuables had broken up. Now here comes Legacy. The youngsters compared to the Valuables here, but they just made their return recently and immediately win the tag team titles, so clearly they're pretty good too.
Exactly. Although they won the titles in a handicap match against Brendan Johnson to get those titles, and that actually led to Brandon quitting on Johnny. But hey, we're not exactly too sad about that. I mean, Legacy, hot young team, now finally capturing gold and looking to prove themselves against the greatest tag team in XWF history, as Diamond Rush starts things off with Xander Wolf. Xander rolls him up.
Going for a quick victory here. Just a one count. Valuables are no pushovers, that is for sure.
Oh. No pushovers at all, but goodness. Continually dropping Diamond Rush on his head.
Hendry's legal now.
There you go. Now, whips him. Oh, no, whips him out of the ring. I thought he was just going to rip him to the ropes, but now he focuses it on Silver Star.
Cheap shot to Silver Star. It takes him out as well.
Gotta do this now. Xander focuses on Diamond Rush, brings it back to the ring, tries to, but nope. Diamond Rush says he's not ready to go in yet.
So he'll go in on his own terms. He does just that. Breaking the count.
Oh!
The count starts over. Now both legal men back in the ring finally.
Xander kind of down right in front. Oh, just getting back up to his feet as we just witnessed Hendry just get tossed.
Oh!
And a power bomb from Diamond Rush.
Out power bomb. Diamond Rush, one of the most dominant competitors in our tag team roster, dominant enough to catch the Intercontinental Championship earlier this season.
Exactly. Like you, like we all have to
as
remember.
As well as the tag titles on his own.
We have to remember the reason why Diamond Rush is technically 8-time tag team champion is because he won the titles all by himself against York Twins, I believe. York Twins.
Yeah, the York Twins match at the Bay, but the double super kick there from Legacy.
Legacy in control.
Oh goodness!
My. What a launching forearm from Xander Wolf. Legacy is out here to make a name for themselves. And honestly, who better? It's now Xander. Diamond Rush trying to get to his corner, but Xander not letting him. Whips him back into his corner. Oh, what a forearm there.
What's he thinking off the ropes?
Knee drop directly over the face of Diamond Rush. But no, Diamond Rush now whips him into his own corner. But then he gets the elbows for his troubles, and then just gets tossed back in. Oh, no.
Tag is made. What are they thinking here?
Goodness. The velocity Wolf and Hendry are traveling at as he hit the code red on Diamond Rush. But does it go for the pin? He wants to do more damage. Oh, missed with the punch. But now Diamond Rush, he's got Hendry clubbing blows to the back. Oh, goodness.
Repeated axe handles finally take him down.
Now he goes to the pin. Doesn't even get a one count.
James Hendry, and Legacy as a whole has been on a run lately. This is only their second match since their return, and oh my goodness, that faint kick.
Using the ring posts is nuts. Oh! Springboard Phoenix Splash!
Don't have to put him away. No, Silverstar breaks it up. Also, Silverstar has not yet been legal in this match.
I was just about to point that out, but thank you for... Well, thank you for stealing my words. Oh, goodness. Oh, no.
And again, this is just basically 2-on-1 handicap like we saw on Battle. Silverstar's been taken out as well.
Package pile driver and a brain buster go for the pin. 1, 2.
And he was... Silverstar made it to the apron, but didn't get back in the ring in time.
Hitting.
That was a big detriment for the Valuables, not tagging him Silverstar once. But Legacy didn't let him. Big win for them tonight.
Exactly. Props to the Young Stars. Capture the tag titles and beating the Valuables.
Now,
you want to take this one?
No, go for it.
Alright, we got the women's champions battling it out. Mama Candy. Fight Women's Champion taking on Amy Reed, the recently crowned Battle Women's Champion. As we recently saw in the last battle, she really took care of business with Kimmy B.
Yeah, that she did, throwing her into that spotlight backstage.
We also got word.
Champion versus champion contest. It's scheduled for one fall, making their way to the ring from Tacoma, Washington, the women's champion, Amy Reed.
You're doing so well, announcer guy. But anyway, we had gotten word that Cammy had to be escorted to a medical facility, and we have not. Actually, no, we did get word that she may be out of the ring indefinitely. maybe have action indefinitely. So any other further updates, we'll try to let you guys know. But Cammy's on the shelf thanks to this woman here.
But will that be the case for Mama Candy tonight? We hope not, but with what we've seen from Amy Reed as of late, that could be a possibility.
Exactly. I mean, before joining the Apocalypse, she was the personification of toughness. And she even was, dare I say, Dottie's greatest rival. But then she joined Apocalypse. Everything's just been different now. I mean, especially her getting more success for herself, winning the Gold Rush briefcase, cashing in on Cammy after a hard-hitting Last Woman Standing match, and finally capturing the Battle Women Championship. Now she faces Mama Candy, and I'm a little worried for Mama Candy here.
As am I, but Mama Candy right off the bat with the boot.
We gotta remember, Mama Candy grew on her own as a singles competitor here. She used to be a valet for Summer Adams. But that now, oh goodness! Now she's a multiple-time women's champion along with her opponent there as Amy Reed's going for a pinfall victory here. Nope, just the one count.
Amy Reed, one of the longest tenured superstars in the XWF. That's total. Mama Candy's been here a while too, but not quite as long.
Exactly. Wait. Mama Candy slipped underneath. Kick to the hamstring. Going for a springboard. Ooh, drop kick.
Can't say Mama Candy has honed her craft over the years.
Exactly. Ooh. Boot right to the jaw of Amy Reed. She's not backing down. Showing some guts and fearlessness. Showing some toughness, dare I say, against the woman that used to be the personification of toughness.
Did you see the distance she got on that?
Did you see the precision on that kick? That landed directly on Amy Reed's jaw.
I mean, like we said, Mama Candy has honed her craft, especially starting not even as an in-ring competitor.
Oh, goodness. She went for another kick there, but Amy has that experience factor. She has the advantage, the experience, as now as she... one of the longest tenured XWF superstars this whole time. She was a wrestler. And goodness, a top row springboard moonsault on the back of Mama Candy. Now just using her feet to choke out the Fight Women's Champion. Things are not looking good for Mama Candy here.
But she's trying to turn things around here.
And is she she's doing the exact same thing back to her.
She sure is, and it's just as effective.
And now Mama Candy going up top out. What she got planned here? Went for a knee drop, but no!
That's devastating on the knees.
And then she gets a flat ladder, and that might be it. One, two, no three.
Not enough to put Candy away yet. She is not out of this fight, but Amy's stalking her. She's got her up.
Wait a minute. That might do it. It does it.
And Amy, very clearly beside herself.
Crowd is loving this with the Fight Forever chance. Wait a minute. Oh, my goodness.
Timing was impeccable. And Candy.
The in-ring, the ring awareness of Mama Candy to avoid Amy's dive, and then to perfectly time a dive of her own. We can't say this enough. She honed her craft to where even she's doing this well against a woman who's been here way longer than her.
Say she's honed her craft, she very well near perfected it.
Count of seven. Amy's got to beat the count if she wants to win this match. She beats the count at eight.
Oh no.
Oh no. There's the inexperience. We talk about Mama Candy's in-ring awareness. We can't forget about Amy's.
One little misstep from Candy led to a devastating crash.
Devastating crash of Berta. She receives a Kamigoye to the face. I like what Amy's got planned here. She's dragging her over to the corner. Mama Candy with those dual clotheslines caught the boot and sweeps her leg.
She's going for the pin right there.
Not even a one count? And a flatliner from Mama Candy this time.
Big flatliner. Now waiting for Amy to get back up. What's she thinking here?
And she's giving her a taste of her own medicine. Whoa!
If Candy ends it on that, she does. Wow.
Are you kidding me?
Here is your winner, Candyman.
That settles the score as far as brand affiliation goes.
Man, what great action we just saw. But ladies and gentlemen, now we've got your Kano champion, Crimson, going head-to-head United States champion, MD. Man, This has you salivating for any real wrestling fans, like especially technical wrestling.
Oh yeah, I know. I'm excited for this one. Crimson and MD, two of the greatest technical wrestlers in the XWF, two of the greatest workhorses in the XWF, both workhorse champions going head to head. This is going to be a banger. I don't ask
why they call on me. Exactly, as Crimson, known for so long as a tag team competitor, started last season making a name for himself in the singles competition, one breakout star of the season, although he came up short in his big matches against Universal Champion Chris Edwards, against Christie and Road to Glory, and against Brandon Styles Extreme Mania. As I've said all that, as I've listed his shortcomings, today he's walking in this ring as Intercontinental Champion. That's to show how it's going.
Yeah, of course, he defeated Diamond Rush, who we talked about earlier, to win the title and has held it since.
Exactly, Diamond Rush. Of course, it was during Diamond Rush's feeling himself Mark after winning the tag team titles all by himself, then not only winning the tournament to get an Intercontinental title shot, he beat Paul Tyson for the Intercontinental Championship.
Just to lose it to Crimson after, what was it, 26 days? Or no, 49 days. Excuse me. Sorry.
That just says a lot about Crimson as a competitor. The man he defeated was on the run of his career. Now Crimson's got another large obstacle in his way, another huge matchup. I guess the man of similar status, although it didn't start out as a tag team competitor, he was known as a promising star. He actually came very close to winning the world championship. But now we get to see these two clash. I'm really excited for it.
Yeah, like I said earlier, I am ecstatic to see these two go to war.
Here comes the United States champion, the Irish Ayatollah, MD.
Not only is he the champion, he's got a brand new piece of metal around his waist.
That title looks really nice.
And his opponent from Belfast, Northern Ireland, weighing in at 228 pounds, the United States Champion, MD.
A little upgrade there, pop, that we see for the United States Championship. More than likely thanks to MD. Again, this is the same guy that apparently, or that we've seen, put the fear of God in Johnny, as not only was he hitting Johnny while Johnny was on top of the ladder, clawing at the World Heavyweight Championship, it made Johnny speed things up rather than go down the punish him. So you gotta think, Crimson has gotta take that into note. This is a man that put fear in the World Heavyweight Champion.
That is very true. As Crimson has one heck of a match ahead of him, but again, you can't denote the wrestler that Crimson is. Because, I mean, these two, I mean, they're comparable in their style, and obviously they're both champions on their respective brands, so clearly this is going to be a pretty even match.
Right, as MD started out with control, but Crimson just took it back from him just quickly. Oh, wait, never mind. Oh, goodness, what a lariat. To the back of the neck. But again, MD back in control. And then he just gets thrown out of the ring. This match has already been 50-50 down the wire.
Dude, lock up. Crimson sitting to the barricade.
And that right there might swing things in his favor. As he just gets sent into the barricade again. Now he's got Crimson. Oh, going for a Cobra Clutch on the outside. This is mainly just to inflict damage, but Crimson finding his way out of it. Count of five.
Oh.
Reverse. MD reversing the hurt of that Irish whip and getting back in the ring at count of six. Count at seven. Crimson's still down. And now he gets back up and breaks the count.
wait a minute. MD.
Oh!
Hurricanrana there. Wait a minute. Crimson. Whoa! What a triangle drop kick from the Intercontinental Champion.
What's he thinking? Ooh.
But wait a minute, MD's got him rolled up.
Tried to just get a one cheap count. Victory there, just a one count. Oh, he hits a sling blade.
Only two.
Two that time, but still not enough to put away Crimson, the Brimstone Phoenix.
No, wait a minute, wait a minute. No. Comet going, ooh, right to the face. Wait a minute. Crimson. Oh! What was that?
I don't know, but it was impressive.
Whatever it was, it didn't keep MD on the ground for long, as now we got a DDT! Oh. MD taking a breather at the corner as Crimson collects himself. Oh, goodness, what a clothesline. But Crimson got back up
to his feet.
You were right, guys. This is going down 50-50. Oh, what a knee from Crimson! My.
Ooh! Forearm. Oh, but he got the knees up.
Got the knees up on the Shooting Star. MD with control. I can see the blood leaking from his, from on top of his eye from that punch. Wait a minute. Crimson. Oh! That might do it. One. Just one? Line. You're kidding me. Oh, wait. Crimson. Oh! Connected with a roundhouse kick to the temple. Oh! And a splash. And it might spell the end. It might spell the end for the United States champion. Oh wait, no!
No.
MD! He caught the kick, but he got set outside for it.
MD writhing in pain on the outside. Crimson gonna follow him out there now. Oh no, he got the knees up again.
He tried it and it failed twice. But now, Crimson. Oh! Ripcord forearm. And then Irish whips it to the other side of the ring. And Crimson gets back in. Count now at five. MD struggling to get up. Barely making any efforts to get up.
We're at a count of six now.
Count of seven, MD needs to get back in the ring. Count of eight, gets back in. Oh! Oh my goodness!
Goodness.
That last shot, that's what won him the title. No!
But it will not win. Put away Crimson here, but look at this. Oh my!
Moonsault to the back of Crimson. Oh, and a drop kick to the temple. And then a kick to the back. My goodness. Now he's just working on that arm. Oh no. He's going for it again, is he? He hits it again.
He hits it again. Is it enough to put away Crimson? No, it's not still.
You're kidding me. Oh, he went for the Shooting Star Press, but Crimson got the knees up. Now Crimson with the Irish whip. Ducks underneath. Leaps over. Oh!
Oh my, what an uppercut. going for the pin. No, it's still not enough.
My goodness.
These two are absolutely tearing each other apart.
As Crimson finally hits that shooting star press. But then gets set out of the ring. Like, this entire matchup, one person has control, but it's not for long. It's almost quickly taken away from this Quickstick took it.
And like I said at the beginning of this match, it's going to be pretty even. And they have exactly proven my point.
Count of two is now MD sends Crimson to the other side of the ring. Now he's taunting him, begging him to get back in the ring. Count of five. Six. Crimson finally get back up, but no, MD just breaks the count.
MD's he goes a better man than letting him lose by count out.
And, oh, goodness. My. Did you see the height he got with that clothesline?
Not enough.
You're kidding me.
These two are just blow for blow going down to the wire here.
And then AFD with the sling blade. Oh!
Oh!
Immediately gets greeted with the kick to the temple.
Now Crimson.
Oh no, oh no, no, no. Working the fingers.
No.
And then double knees to the back. Dropping his body weight on the back of the United States champion.
And Crimson. Now look at
what type of maneuver was that?
One that might put away MD here. No, it's a
no. Something's got to give with these two. Oh, no.
Oh, my.
He went for it again. Got the knees up. As MD leaped over. Oh, caught him.
No.
That's the third one.
Is three the magic number for MD?
It's
no,
not.
It's not.
What's he got? Oh, the blockbuster!
Oh, could this finally be it?
It is.
It is.
Good lord.
My goodness, that, like I said, blow for blow, 50-50 down the middle.
Here is your winner.
MD came out the victor. He
last
takes
second
home the victory.
Everything he had. My goodness, what a match.
Man.
And now we're moving on to the King of the Ring Finals.
Exactly, as here comes Austin Insanity, the favorite for this whole tournament. My goodness, what an epic match he went through against Leon DeSanta.
Yeah, you have to wonder if that will be affecting his performance in this match.
Of course, but then again, like, this is Austin Insanity. He's basically a legend around this part, so, you know, he had to at least come up with a strategy for this. But also, like, on top of the fact, we keep saying this time and time again, he's the only former world champion in the tournament. And that experience alone has to count for something.
That is true. The only person in this tournament to ever hold any sort of world championship gold, trying to get to that once again. Of course, the winner of the ring, as we all should know, gets a title opportunity.
Winner,
yeah, the winner of this match will get a title shot for the respective, a world title shot against their respective brand's champion at Lockdown. So, if I'm...
Or in the case of Austin, it's going to be, of course, the multi-security program, so I guess we'll have to do it after, but maybe we'll go to the video.
Yeah, sure. But... But I'm... If I'm Paul Tyson, I'm
and his opponent from Cleveland, Ohio, weighing in at 195 pounds.
If I'm Paul Tyson, or matter of fact, if I'm Johnny D, I'm watching this match very closely because, as you said, the number one favorites in this match. We also have the number one underdog in the finals, that being Youngblood.
Exactly. Surprised us time and time again in this tournament. Made it all the way to the finals. So.
But it's even more surprising, in order to get into this tournament, he had to pin Johnny. He had to beat Johnny. That was a shock of its own. Granted, he was injured, but still. He broke Johnny's unpinned streak. Might be a 50-50 crowd, because Austin Sandy is a fan favorite in himself. Youngblood has definitely earned the love of the fans.
Yeah, I can tell you one thing, though. The fans are going to love this match regardless of who wins it.
Well, of course, like, especially on paper, with Youngblood's high flying and Austin Sanity's intensity. You're bound to get a great match out of this, especially adding the atmosphere of it being a King of the Ring finals match, as Youngblood.
Right off the bat, Youngblood.
I mean, of course, he's the fresher competitor. His semifinals match was first. It was right before Austin's, so he had more time to recover. But Austin in control here. No. Oh! That was nasty.
Very nasty kick. And now, with a few more for good measure.
But Youngblood taking back control. And now working on the legs. Of course, like we said, he needed to watch Austin's match against Leon very closely, as you saw the springboard. Springboard moves that Austin was pulling out, so of course he's working on the legs to try to negate that that aspect of Austin's offense. As Youngblood, oh goodness,
saved himself but still got hurt.
And as you can see, there's the experience factor for Austin Insanity. He's going for a Cobra Clutch on the outside here? Oh, goodness. And Youngblood able to throw him over to the steps. Count at five. Austin's got to get back in. Oh, he's taking his time. Ooh, what a shot there from Youngblood. Irish whip. Oh, goodness.
Oh, my.
Only a one count. The Youngblood already back. Nope, he's got him. He's got his back.
Oh.
This is gotta hurt. This is definitely gonna hurt. Bend of the fingers. Ooh.
Yeah, these as well.
Austin is definitely going to work on Youngblood. Oh, wait a minute. Signs of life from Youngblood here.
And look at this. Oh, my.
Goodness. Just dropping his back on his knee, but Austin is standing back in control of this matchup. Especially when you're in a matchup with someone of Austin's the same status of Austin said, you got to be on your toes. You got to stay on him. Otherwise, you create a moment of opportunity for him, and that will cost you the match. So, oh, a backstabber!
Goes for the pin. Not enough.
Youngblood. Wait, what's he setting up here? Oh, no!
Oh.
He went for the fly stop, but Austin countered. And now the forearms. Oh, goodness. Into the Death Rider.
The Death Rider. That's got to be it for Youngblood. No.
No way. That was the exact combo that put away Leon DeSanta.
Earlier tonight, yeah.
Oh! Went for a spear, but duck. Oh, wait! Youngblood went for a drop kick and missed.
Strikes. And that's how you know these two are seeing red. They're missing strikes.
Exactly. Both of the, this is their second matchup of the night. And both of their first matches were intense.
Oh! Both went for a springboard at the same time.
Again, that's unlucky. Oh! Codebreaker.
Facebreaker from Youngblood.
I'm sorry, facebreaker, but yeah, both men were down for a moment. Fatigue is setting in.
Oh!
That was a picture-perfect neckbreaker right there from Youngblood there. Ooh!
Oh, but since sends him out of the ring. Austin getting himself hyped up here.
He goes out of the ring. Oh!
Oh!
Missed with that kick. Youngblood now. Oh! Tilt the war into an arm bar, into a Fujiwara arm bar.
Now, likely did some damage to the elbow of Insanity.
Exactly.
But takes more than a little elbow damage to take out the former Universal Champion.
Goodness, that was ugly. But Youngblood just kept
somehow
up.
Somehow Youngblood kips up.
Wait a minute here.
Now Youngblood. Oh my! Planting Austin face first in the center of the ring. Now what's he thinking?
Oh wait, the crossface again!
Oh, he's gonna put the crossface in and he's got it locked in!
It's locked in.
And Austin taps!
No way! No way! He just won! You're kidding me!
Youngblood. Youngblood is your king of the ring, ladies and gentlemen.
The underdog pulls off the biggest upset. He clears the field. Man, I can't believe he actually did it, but ladies and gentlemen, it's time for the main event. Now, 13 hinted at this earlier. It's not just the battle of the brands. This is a battle for the whole company. We've got the team of Chris Edwards, Christy, Gary Ford, and 13 against Johnny D, Paul Tyson, Reaper Killer, and who was once Brandon Johnson, but as of last battle, he quit.
Of course, that left Johnny without a teammate. So, we don't actually even know if he's found a replacement or if they're going in as a handicap. I'm not sure. Is it a man?
announcer got the memo, or either he didn't get the memo or he got a newly updated memo, because he just announced it as an 8-man tag, so.
Well, it was originally billed as an 8-man tag. You could be confused, or maybe it is.
I mean,
knowing Johnny, he's got some connections that he seems to know a lot of people as well.
Knowing Johnny, does. That's the problem. He's any allies he would have had when he first started. He's made them enemies.
I guess that's fair. He knows a lot of people, but finding one that actually likes him is a different story.
Heck, one of those people's on his team. Comes the former Universal Champion Gary Ford. As we saw, 13 sporting some camo there, signaling that this very well is a war.
We are going to war here tonight.
And his partners from Indianapolis, Indiana, weighing in at 215 pounds, Gary Ford.
Gary Ford with some attire inspired by the Call of Duty character Ghost.
Catching a theme here.
I'm digging it. I mean, he still kept with the theme of camo, you know, going to war. He just decided to up the ante with the Call of Duty character cosplay. I mean, I'm not gonna fault him for it. It's a great character to cosplay.
Gary's notorious for doing such outfits.
Well made point there. Is Gary looking, trying to hype up the crowd? Obviously, we know which team this crowd supports. Apparently, I'm hearing from, looking at Gary's Twitter, apparently all the attires are Call of Duty? Huh.
And from Transylvania,
here's Christy.
Weighing in at 265 pounds.
A former Universal Champion. That's two. There's a second former Universal Champion, of course. He and Gary have had a rough patch, especially last season, stemming from lockdown and onwards. To put those differences aside, for an even larger cause.
Gonna put everything on the line here, I think. And I mean, to possibly try and take down Johnny and his tyrannical being. And here comes Chris Edwards.
And from Miami, Florida, weighing in at 223 pounds, Chris
Pretty sure that although they may have a mantra of no leaders among this team, but if I were to pick out anyone to be the leader of this team, it has to be Chris.
I mean, he's in a way kind of the one that organized it all, right? I mean, he's the one that got 13 to join him. He's the one that finally agreed with Gary and Christy.
right? Which is definitely saying something, because Chris Edwards was known as the face of the company. He's known as the GOAT of XWF. And he's also known to have one of the biggest egos. But, and that's actually saying something, that he's willing to put off his differences aside, especially given that his Universal title run ended at Extreme Mania, ended at the hands of Gary Ford.
But, I mean, he was willing to team up with them. I mean, he's made it very blatantly clear he's not necessarily friends with them, but he says they all agree and they're all here to take down Johnny.
Exactly, as now the four are in the ring and we're going to see Johnny's team step out. Even with just being the three of them, that is a scary sight.
So you have the most dominant people in XWF right now. You can't imagine who they might have had as their fourth. Previously just Brandon Johnson, which is scary enough as it is. But of course, Brandon chose the moral high ground, left the company.
And at a combined weight of 808 pounds,
Morris was known, well, it's kind of ancient history here, and what kind of gives this team the advantage, even with just the three of them, is the fact that Johnny D and Reaper Killer were tag team partners back in the day on the indie scene. They were one of the most dangerous tag teams back then. So the fact that they're teaming up again, you have to at least be worried.
Paul Tyson to the mix as well, who has pledged allegiance to the TDC.
Exactly. How can we forget Paul Tyson? He's former Intercontinental Champion, longest reign. I believe he's the longest reigning Intercontinental Champion of all time.
That would be correct.
He's very, I believe he's very close to breaking that Universal title record.
He is very close, on his way. On his way to breaking that title reign record, which is currently held by Chris Edwards.
Exactly. On top of that, he was the GOAT. He's a men's Gold Rush winner. Did that as Intercontinental champion. Holding both belts for a good minute. And of course, he's backed by Johnny. Even with just these three, this team is scary.
I'm not sure if they even need a fourth.
You might be right there again. Like, of course, longest reigning Intercontinental champion of all time, Paul Tyson. First man to hold the Universal and Intercontinental title at the same time. Former Gold Rush winner. Then you got Reaper Killer here. One of the most dangerous entities who have ever set foot in XWF. And then you got Johnny D, the only person to have ever held a title for over a year. And that being the World Heavyweight Championship.
Like I said when I first stepped out here, three of the most dominant competitors in the XWF today.
Exactly. I mean, it's obvious who I'm rooting for here. I'm not rooting for these three. Let's not get it twisted.
No, we're just speaking the facts.
Come on.
Here. Can't argue with facts.
Let's not forget my epic tirade I went on at Extreme Mania when this man won his belt by cheating.
Remember. Know me.
You know me.
Remember.
Say my name.
My name.
Say my name.
Say my name.
You know me.
Remember.
Remember. Remember. Remember.
What?
What?
What? No way. You're kidding me.
No.
Indianapolis, Indiana. Last time we were battling the brands, Johnny D destroyed this man. These two, they shouldn't get along. What is this?
I have not seen Jay Gunn in 8 months. And he's back. I guess the old mantra, if you can't beat him, join him, but... What?
I really don't. But it's happening. It's Johnny D and 13 start this off.
Jay Glenn is the fourth man.
But What? Regardless, now Johnny's in control of this matchup. He's working on the arm of 13 here. This is insane.
I'm at a loss for words here. I'm supposed to commentate this match.
I mean, granted, it must be a recurring theme, as we remember the three men on in 13's corner. They were the main event of Extreme Mania 2 for the Universal title. Then you got Reaper Killer on the other side, feuded with Johnny. Then Paul Tyson and Jay Glenn's feud. And now they're teaming together?
Like you said, it's a recurring theme. I'm confused, but it's happening.
It's Paul Tyson taking control of Christie, and now he's targeting Gary. And 13.
13 strikes
Wait,
back.
Oh, no.
Christy.
The STO and the Universal Champion. Oh, and then an elbow to the back. Oh, and choking him out. Not letting up on the champion here. Nope,
Christy
Irish whip reverse.
Nope.
Goodness, that kick to the knee. Oh, wait. Oh, what an uppercut from the champion. Go for the pin.
Two. Oh, he
and
used
a rope.
Break.
That's great in-ring awareness from Christy. Of course, that man, the man used to be Universal Champion, He used to be the longest reigning Universal Champion. He's currently number three on that list. Or number two, I'm sorry, on that list. Now he's got control. Ooh, goodness. Combination from the Soul of XWF. Going for the pin.
Just a one.
Just a kick out. Ooh! The pin was just broken up there by Chris Edwards before it could even start. Now, Christy! Oh! That counter. Back to control again. No, countered again!
Oh, cheap shot to Gary. Gets him out of the ring. And,
Oh, no.
Christy's busted open.
He caught a spear!
Christy took that personally. Gave him a spear for his troubles. Oh, but
Tyson. Wait a minute. Oh, no.
Going for the pin to end this thing early. 13 breaks it up.
Well, Tyson's losing as Gary Ford's tagged in now. Well, you didn't see it.
Of course, Tyson and Ford have been at each other's throats as of late. They've got a match coming up at Lockdown for the Universal title.
Of course, before the pin could even start, Johnny breaks it up.
But Gary.
Wait a minute, now Gary going after Johnny. Ooh!
Gary, the man who called.
Russian leg sweep.
Gary, the man who called Johnny D a tyrant on Twitter the other day when the poster for Battle of the Brands was released.
That post, as Chris Evers sent out of the ring, but that post convinced me that Gary must have went to an art school or something. That was actually pretty good. Oh my! Good lord, that forearm shot!
Edwards crumbled to the ground, but the pin's broken up by Christy.
That is the same forearm shot that actually set Gate Jake Lynn to the unemployment line at Extreme Mania. Yet. Well, thank God for Christy, because that could have ended the match right there. And now Johnny. Johnny's got Chris Edwards.
Oh, he's going for a ride.
Oh! Danger's power, but wait a minute, rolled up!
Not even a one count.
And to clear up any any confusions, this is one fall to a finish.
Yeah, it's not elimination, nothing like that. This is a clean 4-on-4 tag match, one fall.
And Gary gets back in. Oh! Gary with the neck breaker on Johnny. And hot tag Jay Glenn in the match
for the
first time.
First time in 8 months.
As he goes after Gary.
Oh, and he's on a rampage.
Eight. Goodness.
Jay Glenn has history with Gary Ford as well.
Gary, he has history with three quarters of that team.
Oh, this is very true.
He main evented the first Extreme Mania with Chris Edwards.
This is very true, but Gary's the one in the ring right now. Of course, most recently, Jay Glenn had cost Gary his career at the Royal Rumble. Obviously, that got vetoed by the CEO, but nonetheless, Jay Glenn is, like I said, on a rampage right now.
Exactly as he went for SCO, but no, Gary counted out of it. Oh, no.
Oh, my.
Pile driver.
Oh, my.
One of the most dangerous moves in wrestling.
But Jay gets right back up.
Jay Glenn almost.
And here comes the 13.
Quickly.
A man that Jay Glenn does not know.
Exactly. This is the first time crossing passes.
Oh, the
oh goodness. He hit the X-Plex already.
Broken up by Chris Edwards.
Oh, no.
Reaper Killer.
Now Reaper Killer finally going to get his hands on 13.
Oh
Luke Death Press.
Now these two.
The hatred between.
Like you're saying, the hatred between these two has no bounds. These two have been at each other's throat for months now.
I think it all started at the Royal Rumble when Reaper Killer eliminated 13. During his triumphant, or what in his mind should have been his triumphant return. And it's gone so far as both these men cost each other their King of the Ring tournament matches. Oh, goodness! As while Christy takes care of Reaper Killer on the outside, Chris Edwards is going after Team Johnny, but no! Just caught a forearm from Paul Tyson, but Reaper Killer back in the ring. Chris is still going after Team Johnny.
Oh!
Just a one count, but that lariat is the same lariat that took out 13 in their most recent matchup. And now Chris going after Tyson.
Oh, but Tyson fighting out here. Allen gets caught by Reaper Killer. Oh my!
This is insane. And wait a minute.
Into
oh, goodness. Reaper Killer was just set it to the table right in front of us.
I always get.
That's
I get nervous.
That's closer than I. Exactly. That's closer than I ever want to be to Reaper Killer. As oh, goodness. Went after Johnny. But Johnny. Demon's Wrath. That was Demon's Wrath.
7, and Reaper Killer breaks it.
Possibly couldn't have won them the match if Reaper Killer didn't go to the outside. Again, this is what Brandon was hinting at, Reaper Killer's unpredictability.
Yeah, I mean, that was...
Oh, goodness!
That was one of Brandon's main complaints when, with Johnny D as of late, that he decided to add Reaper Killer to the match, which ultimately led to Brandon Johnson quitting. But now look at Chris Edwards going for the wide B! And he hits it on Reaper Killer, goes for the pin, but it's broken up by Tyson.
Broken up by the Universal Champions. He gets sent out of the ring into Jay Glenn as he tags in Gary Ford. And oh, goodness, what a kick. Wait, Gary, oh!
Goes for the pin on Reaper Killer, broken up by Johnny before it could even begin.
Now, tags in, Christie's in there against Reaper Killer. Oh, goodness, a kick to the leg, another one. And that third one sends her probably go for the pin here. Only two. Frequent tags here between Team Chris, Team Edwards.
Oh,
goodness. Oh, those are nasty headbutts as he keeps going. Gary able to fight out of the corner. Oh, wait a minute.
Rolling him up. Just a one.
And another headbutt. Goodness. Now Johnny's in there. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, no. This is the move that he beat Christy with. He calls this a Lordstown shutdown.
My.
But 13 breaks it up.
At a one count.
Exactly, but Oh no, no. Demons are at the get on Gary this time in the ring. Christy breaking things up. Oh goodness. Another powerbomb, 13 in there. Now finally getting his hands on Johnny. Of course, these two were the main event of Bash at the Bay. 13 was screwed out of his world title match against Johnny. Oh, goodness.
Vicious lariat.
Oh, no. Now demonstrating his strength, his demonic strength.
Oh, just dropping 13 to the mat. Johnny's going high risk.
What a flying lariat. Just imagine someone 6'4", 290 pounds, just leaping, like just plunging themselves directly at you.
I would not want to be in 13 shoes, and that's why I'm behind this table.
Exactly. As now, get Jake Lynn in the ring with 13. Is 13 whipped into the ropes? Oh, powerbomb on Jake Lynn.
Sent into the corner.
What's he got playing? Oh my goodness, a dragon sleeper, just a hanging dragon sleeper. Of course, he couldn't keep it locked in at the risk of disqualification, but that surely did some damage.
Yeah, definitely. Definitely did something, as Jay Glenn is unresponsive and
Jay Glenn kicked up, but into a spear.
Broken up by Reaper Killer immediately.
Christy looks like he's setting up for Heartless Alpha. No! Glenn counter. Oh! Now Jay tags in Johnny. Ooh! What a forearm there from Christy. Oh no! Johnny used his weight against him.
Latin Christy in the process.
Christy able to kick. Christy able to kick his way out of that. Now he goes to the pin. One, just a one count. Now wait a minute.
Oh, Christy.
Christy with that cross face. Can he get Johnny to tap? No, Johnny powers his way out as Jay Glenn was coming over there just in case. Oh, he gets, Christy just got a shot in the back for both Tyson and Reaper Killer. Oh no. Getting hit from all around.
Christy around.
Oh no, Johnny displaying that strength again. With two backbreakers. Christy kipping up, but it's too late. Tyson's in. Wait a minute. He just did Heartless Downfall to Christy. Oh! Christy's got to be out, but no, Gary keeps him alive.
Immediately. That is one of the biggest factors in this being an 8-man tag match. The chances of a pin getting to 3 are low.
As the rep, did Gary accidentally hit the ref on the way there?
Must have, because he is not moving.
Ref? Now, half and half soup. I believe that's half and half. I'm not sure. Whatever, it was a dangerous suplex from the Universal Champion on a Chris, on a Christy. Ref finally back up. Oh, goodness! Overhead belly to belly.
Christy might have hit his head on the ground. Christie is not moving.
His head's already busted open. He's already leaking from the forehead. His head's taking a lot of damage here.
Count of six. He's going to need to get back in the ring.
Count of nine. Christie's got to get in there to break the count. He does. A sling blade and a drop kick. And now Edwards back in this matchup. Oh goodness. I think he may have went for something there, but Tyson caught him with that, caught him with a strained knee there. Deltor backbreaker from the heart of XWF. And now, oh goodness! Now he's going after Team Johnny. That dropkick set Reaper Killer off the apron. Now he's tagging him forward. Gary, oh! That had to have knocked Paul's lights out.
No, it didn't.
Apparently it didn't. Gary. Oh!
Ooh.
Tyson moved out the way. And now... Tyson... Oh, my goodness! Was that a choke bomb?
Whatever it was pretty effective as Gary's stunned in the corner here.
Take control here. Oh! Vicious assault. He goes for a pin there. Just a one count. Now he goes after. Oh no, 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 no. No. Christie's already taken enough damage to the head. Oh!
Oh.
Apron DDT. Christie got it back up on his feet almost immediately. And wait a minute. Tristan Decophobia. And was almost immediately broken up by Tyson.
Okay. Flex on 13.
Just kicking out though. It's now Glenn in control.
Oh!
Goodness! Oh no! Edwards is leaking.
Edwards now busted open as well.
That doesn't seem to bother him one bit though. He has control over Glenn in this matchup. Oh! Kicked to the gut from Glenn.
Tag's made to Johnny now.
Johnny's back in.
And ooh!
DDT there from the world champion, but Edwards still not backing down, still not out of it. Spike taking a vicious DDT. Ooh!
Works for the pin. Just a two count.
Two count, but that was very close to a three.
Very close.
Missed with that kick, but now Johnny's got control. Oh, sidewalk slam. And an elbow drop on the back.
That really had to hurt, and he's doing it again. Goodness!
Ooh, face first on the top turnbuckle. Oh, my.
Drop kick there from Edwards. And Edwards got... Oh, no. Johnny's got control again. Oh, no.
Oh, no.
Oh, no. He's got him in the... No, jawbreaker from Edwards. Iconic can't tell whether... Because there's been multiple variations of the Demon's Grip. I don't know if that's the new variation of it.
Oh, but look at Edwards.
Speaking of variations, here's one of the wide B!
Broken up by Jay.
Broken up almost immediately, right before the one count. Johnny has to roll out the ring.
Right back up onto the apron.
Exactly. Ooh, just with that drop kick. Tyson's in there. That gets out. Tina and Christy went after Johnny on the outside.
Ford is legal now. If Johnny gets back into the ring. I do believe he did see the tag. But Edwards still in the ring, needs to get out. And look at this, Johnny. Oh no.
Wait a minute.
No!
Oh!
Tags in Reaper Killer.
That lariat almost flipped him inside out. Wait a minute!
But Gary!
Gary! Oh.
Tagged in Christy.
Could have immediately went for the pin, though. Instead, he tags in Christy to do more damage. Now Christy's got Reaper Killer on the shoulder. Snake Eyes! And there's Reaper. Oh, wait a minute.
Ooh!
Gutbuster there from Christy.
Taking him down in the crossface.
And now
Paul Tyson.
Is Reaper gonna cut a tap?
Wait a second.
Oh, wait a minute.
Paul's got Gary and he's sending him up the ramp.
These two are just brawling out there.
These two brawling up the ramp right now. We still got a match going on in the ring.
Oh, goodness. They just sent him into that light. I mean, they're not legal. They're not legally in the match, so this technically counts. Oh, man. We have another official here. He's trying to, I don't know, I guess he's trying to convince him to go back. But it's kind of hard to do that with all this tension in all in this matchup. Christy just got a back suplex on the apron, but still up on his feet almost immediately.
I mean, there are no rules that say you can't fight if you're not legally in the match on the outside, so...
Exactly. As he counts at five. Christy and Reaper Killer, they both got to get back in the ring. Christy sends Reaper Killer back in. But now, tags in Glenn. Count of eight, Christy broke it up.
Oh my.
Oh, good. Lord.
Goes for the pin on Christy. Not enough.
Christy now. Oh, Christy. I'm sorry. Christy just fighting out of it now. But then Jay. Oh, back and forth between these two. Gotta remember, these two went to war against each other over the Universal title. They probably know each other pretty well.
And oh, but still back on the ramp, Gary. The stomp of his own there, and now sending him up to the entryway.
Still fighting. Of course, Gary considered Paul a friend before Paul cashed in on him. He basically joined forces with Johnny.
The 13 is legal for Team Edwards now. I guess that's what we're calling him.
An elbow there from 13. He says Glenn into his corner. Jay able to fight out of it. Wait a minute. Oh! First DDT, and of course 13 soaking the moment in, but here comes Johnny D. But he got this uppercut instead. But Johnny's back on his feet. Goodness! Oh my God, what a drop kick. I mean, I guess they chose riding in cosplay Call of Duty, where are the camo, because this is definitely a war right here.
Yeah, if I've ever seen one.
Now they're getting close to us. As 13, oh! Saito suplex sending Johnny colliding with the steel steps.
Oh! Forearm there.
Went after Reaper Kill. He went after Reaper Kill there. He paid the price for it. Pays again. Oh!
A tag made to Christie. Oh, a spear!
Oh! Spear, he leaped over 13! But Johnny breaks it up at one.
And still
Gary and Paul on the stage. This is deep hatred. They don't care about the match going on out here. They're looking to get it on the outside. That's a sit-out powerbomb from Ford.
Gary, oh no!
Oh my God!
He tossed him off the stage. That's like 6 feet. Nearly. And Gary!
Oh!
But in the ring, Chris going for a pin on Reaper Killer. This might be over.
No, Reaper Killer kicks out. But Chris, he saw Glenn try to break it up.
I think it's safe to say Paul Tyson and Gary Ford might be out of this thing.
That might be right. Oh! Oh, no! Reaper Killer went for the bicycle kick on Glenn, but he hit... Oh, sorry, he went for the bicycle kick on Edwards, but hit Glenn. Of course, they were able to brush aside that mishap for a second there, but... Man!
Doing damage to your own teammates.
Again, the unpredictability, the recklessness of Reaper Killer.
Like Brandon Johnson said, you never know. Now Edwards again going for the pin.
But again, Reaper Killer kicks out. Now Chris. The right side of his forehead, nothing but red.
Battle scars being shown mostly on the side of Chris Edwards, but battle scars nonetheless.
Again with that clothesline, and then an elbow drop to the sternum of Reaper Killer. Sending Reaper Killer back into the corner. Tags in 13.
Double teaming Reaper Killer.
Fisherman suplex. 13, obviously cocky. He's got Reaper Killer right where he wants him. Wait, what?
What?
What the?
What do we even do now? They're gone. Oh.
Wait a minute. How do they...
The unpredictability of Reaper Killer. These two are fighting in the parking lot. I don't know. Are we calling them? I mean, they were both legal.
They're legal. There should be a cow going on.
I don't think anybody knows what to do. These two are just fighting in the garage.
Oh, good lord! 13 just hurled a stop sign at Reaper Killer. But Reaper Killer now gonna power. Oh!
On the concrete. And these guys have just gotten to a full out brawl. I think Johnny D told them to continue the match regardless.
Flexing his powers. Now a suplex toss. And oh! I think Chrissy made contact, but it didn't matter.
I guess Christie's the legal man and Johnny D, but I mean the three of them were all just brawling there for a moment.
Exactly, Johnny just taking the rest, and now he's tagging in Glenn. Christie's getting back up and counted two. Now Glenn chases after him. Christie already back in the ring. He's focused on Johnny.
Oh! Oh, but there's Jay.
Irish rip, ducks underneath. Oh, wait, no. Chrissy uses the ropes to escape out of that. Gets a room, but I don't think it worked well enough in his favor.
I mean, Christy's got some unparalleled ring awareness, but clearly it wasn't enough to save him entirely.
Both of these men are former Universal Champions. Christie, the second longest reigning Universal Champion of all time. Jay Glenn, the only man to hold the Universal Championship twice.
Oh.
Good.
And wait back to the parking lot.
They're still brawling?
These two are still just going at it. And 13's got the trash can.
And what is he?
Oh!
Nope! Reaper Killer able to take it out of his hands. Tossing 13 away from it. Goodness! Now, what is he? I mean, you talk about the hatred, deep hatred flowing all the way through this matchup. I mean, we just saw Gary Ford and Paul Tyson just say screw the match and then brawl with each other on the stage. Now we're seeing these two brawl with each other backstage. Oh, he just threw a shovel at him!
This is just delved into chaos here.
And now Reaper Killer. Oh! And now Glenn tagging in Johnny as Edwards was tagged in by Chrissy. Oh, the DDT. Oh, what a form. Sending Johnny D crumbling. But of course, Johnny able to get out of the way for that double X handle. Now he's got him on his shoulders. Oh! Wait a minute. Oh! Edwards, what's he got planned? Oh, a splash! Oh, goodness. Again with the arm. Johnny, where? Oh, no, no, no.
Oh, no.
No, 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 not again.
No, my.
Another Lordstown shutdown, but he's not done. A counter. Goodness.
Oh no! Christie gets the tag in. And Johnny immediately raining down strikes.
He had him bulked out for a second, just for one count on Christie. But wait a minute, Christy, get back up. Johnny still has control. No, Christy fighting out, refusing to go down.
Oh, and a sling blade.
Sling blade.
Trying to take out Jake Lynn in the process, but going for the pin on Johnny.
Oh, goodness. Wait a minute.
Backstage again.
Yep. Oh, no.
Oh, my goodness.
Look at 13's face.
13 has just been bludgeoned backstage as this match is going on. And oh, my goodness.
Oh, my God.
He hit it. He hit the Triskaidekaphobia on the concrete. And he's still not done.
Of course he knows that's not going to be... That's not going to be enough to take out Reaper Killer. It's Reaper Killer as we return to the ring. Johnny and Edwards are illegal. Ooh! Discus punch from the world champion. A battle between the team captains.
Oh.
Playing out in front of us.
Tag's made to Jay Glenn.
Oh. Ooh!
Edwards goes
go for the pin.
That's a two.
Only two. Edwards sent him into the corner.
Ooh! You hear that one from the rafters, my goodness.
I bet you Reaper Killer 13 heard that chop. Oh, goodness. Christy trying to follow up with it, but Glenn now roaring back into control, using that forearm to choke out the oxygen. They're still at it backstage.
I don't know how much longer these two are going to fight each other. And my goodness.
Oh, my. Saito suplex.
13 might be trying to take out Reaper Killer entirely. Oh!
Oh! As we cut from a Triskaidekaphobia again on the outside, Christy just took, I believe he just took down Glenn with a spear. But Glenn escaping back into the ring. Count of five. Oh!
I'm getting word that Reaper Killer has not moved since then. 13 is leaving the area.
Exactly. Again, did you see 13's face? Like his... He's gonna. Man, that is. Both of these men are gonna require some medical attention from that type of brawl. As now, Kristen Edwards taking out Glenn. He's now the legal man in this match.
This is an 8-man tag team match, and we're down to just 4 men in the ring.
Yeah, this was an elimination, by the way. This is supposed to be one fall to a finish.
We've yet to have a fall, so the match goes on, and Edwards with a diving elbow.
You see the height he got with that. Count of one. With abnormal speed from Johnny. As he reverses the Irish Whip and sends Chris Edwards out of the ring. Oh, no. No, no, no. Again, targeting the head of Christy. Oh, with that apron DDT.
Edwards sends him halfway across the ringside area. And oh!
What a right, what a left there from the former world and universal champion. As he says, get Glenn back into the ring. He's got control of him now. Ooh!
Oh! Face first on the turnbuckle.
No. Now he's bleeding. Oh no.
Busted open as well, and look at this. Edwards, for the second time tonight, going for the avalanche wide beam.
That might be it. One, two. It's not?
Jay Glenn kicks out at two.
And notice Johnny didn't help him.
He was confident.
Now, I guess so. Glenn now. Chris. Oh, and a cheap shot from Johnny.
Wow.
And now Edwards getting choked out. Come on.
Tagging in Johnny D again.
Oh, no. DDT. Oh, goodness. Johnny with control. Wait a minute. I was just about to say Johnny with control. Oh, no. As he takes it back. Almost as fast as he lost it, and now Glenn's back in this match. Oh, goodness.
Taking out the legs. Goes for the pin on Edwards. Is it enough to put him away to end this thing? No.
This is nuts. Every match we've had. Oh! That's got to be it. No, not even a one count. Christy breaking it up before the ref could start. Oh, Edwards is going for something, but he caught a kitchen knee to this kitchen sink to the temple. Now, oh! And now Christy back in this match. Wait a minute. Glenn now. Snap mirror. Oh, and a drop kick to the temple. Again, Christy's head has been a major target for this matchup, as now he's tagging Johnny back in. It's,
oh no.
Demon's grip, but no. Christy with the jawbreaker to break it up. And,
Chris back into this match. And Johnny!
Just lays him out with a lariat. And deadlifts him up for a power slam!
Now tagging Jay Glenn back in.
Glenn back in this match. Oh! He just caught a forearm!
Goodness. And, oh, Edwards not done. Suplex.
Another suplex.
And for good measure, he hits a third.
And a kip up to kick it, to add that little cherry on top. Now just raking his face with that forearm. Wait, Glenn, oh goodness. Get that hurricanrana from off his back. Now, working on the left arm, wrenching at the left arm of Edwards. Oh, no, Edwards with an elbow. Is he going for a YB here?
This. He's going for the YB.
Oh, he hits it. But Edwards too exhausted. Both men are down.
And these men have been at it for an hour at this point. I don't blame them for being a little tired.
It almost seems to have no end up. Back body drop on Glenn. Edwards goes for the pin.
For the pin, broken up by Johnny.
And Johnny breaks it up. Oh, Chrissy thought he whipped it to the ropes for a drop kick, but again, that might be the blood starting to get into his eye. Now Glenn tagging in Johnny. And wait a minute! Oh. Wait a minute!
Jay Glenn!
X-Plex!
Just
what?
Hit the X-Plex on Johnny D!
He's on yours.
Wait, what did you say?
Finish him.
What did you say?
He said, finish him. Jake Lynn's leaving the arena.
What?
Edwards. He's got Johnny D set up for the wide big and he hits it.
The exhaustion you can just feel off Edwards. Almost hesitated to cover him in disbelief. Two. Oh my God.
Johnny D has no one to save him.
He did it.
Here are your winners.
Jake Lynn. And now, Gary, oh my goodness.
Oh my God, I kind of want to cry right now. They did it.
40 to 13, there, making their way back up here to celebrate with their teammates. My goodness.
I can't look at 13. After this, he's got to pay a trip to the hospital.
I mean, I think all eight of these men need to see a doctor after this match. My goodness. But they did it.
What a main event. And Chris Edwards and Johnny, this is amazing. Wait a minute! Johnny's being assaulted right now!
These guys came out with Jay Glenn earlier. Where's the other one? Oh, there he is! But who?
Wait, is that Eddie?
Well,
that's Eddie Tyson!
No way!
Oh my God! No way!
Shane Moore.